Welcome to Northern Lights over Arkham. I'm JP, and this time we'll be playing Dexter Drake in the finale of the Dream Eaters Web of Dreams campaign cycle, the Weaver of the Cosmos. So this only just released in the US, so if you haven't still played this scenario, I'll suggest you play it before watching this video, because there will be spoilers throughout the video. I won't go into detail on the story, but the mechanics will be spoiled throughout. So, with the spoiler warning done, let's look at the deck. Dexter's deck has been added with the 7 XP that we got from the Point of No Return scenario. I've upgraded the Mist of Relay to level 4, and also I've added one Moxie, and I replaced one Lucky Cigarette Case with the Moxie. Also, I've added two Momentums into the deck, and because there's going to be a lot of swarming enemies and a lot of enemies in set locations, I opted to use my adaptable to change the two Spirit Racer cars to two Storm of Spirits. So I have some AoE damage dealing going on. Other than that, the deck is quite the same as before. We start the game with two mental trauma and one physical trauma suffered from the previous scenarios. That's enough of the deck. Let's see the setup. So, because of the tally marks, we added one doom to the bottommost great web location. So the more tally marks you have, the more doom will be added here. That will speed up the first agenda, and also this has a scaling agenda regarding to the amount of players, so the agenda 1A gets a plus 2 doom threshold for each investigator, so even if it says 7, it's 9, and when we advance we do not remove doom from locations in play. The objective is to get to the bottom of the locations and have 3 clues per investigator to advance, and the advancement is a big setup in midst the scenario, so I'll be pausing again when I get there. Okay, well, that's enough of the scenario and the deck. Let's get going.
If you like my content, hit the subscribe button, so you don't miss anything.
I have pre-shuffled the decks, so let's draw our opening hand. I get quick thinking, drawn to the flame Leo De Luca, 41 Derringer and sign magic. Well, I have I think I'll only get rid of sign magic and quick thinking. I'll keep the Derringer, Leo, and Drawn to the Flame. Drawn to the Flame I'll keep because there's already 2 clues on our starting location, so we get a fast start with the clue getting. Let's draw 2 cards, so we get Sixth Sense, that's really good. And we get a Lone Wolf, that's also decent in the start. We have lots of assets to play, and not many resources to play them. But I'll think we won't play Leo down right away. We need to build up some resources to play him. So I think Lone Wolf and Sixth Sense will be logical to play in the start. And on the second turn maybe the Derringer. After that, I'll try to build up for Leo, and let's go from there. Okay, first action. Let's play down Lone Wolf. One resource. Second action, let's play down Sixth Sense. Actually, because there's a lot of enemies in the deck, I think I'll rather play the Derringer down first, because we're not even investigating this turn, and we are using this Drawn to the Flame, and we might pull an enemy, so I think this is a safer route to take, that we play the Derringer down. And last action, I'll Drawn to the Flame, so we get an encounter card. It's a Crypt Chill. So I am testing 5 versus 4. And now, because we have a Lone Wolf in play, that's a safe asset to discard, even if we fail this. So 5 versus 4, we get a Skull. And Skull is X, and X is the highest amount of doom on locations in play, so it's a minus 1, so we pass. Nice, so we don't have to discard anything. And we get the clues. And that's our turn. So, no enemies, we go to upkeep, we get one resource, and we draw one card. And we get the War of Protection, nice. That's the first turn. Let's go to the second turn. We add a Doom to the agenda. And the encounter card is Web Spinner. Spawn any empty location. It's aloof. Forced at the end of the round, if Web Spinner is ready, place one Doom on the Web Spinner's location. So, to stop this guy from placing a lot of Doom, I think I'll put it to the next location, so we can just move in, engage, and shoot to kill. And at the start of my turn, I'll get a resource from Lone Wolf. And first action, let's move into the location. Second action, we'll engage the Web Spinner. And last action, oh yeah, let's reveal the location. Forced, after you enter this location, test Agility 3. If you fail, you must either lose one action for each point you failed by, or place one Doom on this location. I test 2 versus 3. Let's not forget about that blue token. So 2 versus 3, I need a plus 1 or an Elder Sign to succeed. A minus 1. So I would lose 2 actions, but I'll opt to just put a Doom down here. Okay, so the second action was to engage. Third action, we'll use the Derringer to shoot. I am 5 versus 2. I really don't have anything to boost the skill test with. So let's try to kill this spider off. So I need a minus 2 or better to hit, and preferably I need a minus 1 or better to kill it. It's a minus 2, so we only do 1 damage to it, unfortunately. And that's our turn. This spider hits us. Take 1 horror and 1 damage. And at the end of the round, we place 1 Doom on this location. That's also the enemy phase done, so we go to upkeep. We get easy mark and 1 resource. That's that turn. let's go to the next turn. So we are at 5 doom of 9. The encounter card is Obscuring Fog. Attached location gets plus 2 shroud. I think I won't be investigating this location. There's no restriction to just keep moving. As in some scenarios. So I can just ignore this location and move on to get the clues from another location. There is an advantage to get as many clues as you can from these starting locations, but more on that later on in the scenario. So, first action. I'll just try to punch this spider. So I'm 3 versus 2. I don't see... Oh yeah, and the lone wolf resource before we get that. So I don't see a point in wasting ammo to just deal 1 damage. So we need a minus 1 or better. It's a 0. We managed to kill off this spider. So it won't be pooping out any more doom on that location. The next action will play down Sixth Sense. Actually, let's back up a bit. We have enough resources to play down Leo. So I hope to play down Leo. And then I'll play Easy Mark to get 2 resources and draw 1 card. We get Moxie. Actually, I didn't talk a lot about why I added Moxie to the deck. It's because it's a fast action, it's an asset. So I think it combos well with Dexter. And you can boost your agility with it and also your will. So it's kind of a safety card for Dexter if you really need to pass a agility test. So Moxie, I think, is really good in Dexter. And I'm a bit bummed out that I didn't add it in the second scenario. Let's move again with our last action. We come to the Tangled Web. There's 2 clues here. When the investigation phase ends, if there is at least 1 investigator on this location, place 1 doom on this location. So that is not really nice. Nothing we can do about it, so we add 1 doom here. We are already at 6 doom, so as you can see, the doom piles up really fast in this scenario. It's basically a race in the Act 1 to get to the bottom and advance. Okay, no enemies. We go to upkeep. We get 1 resource and draw 1 card, and it's the upgraded Mist of Relay. That's really good. And that's our turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, we add another doom, so we are 7 of 9 doom now. And we get an encounter card. That's Sickening Webs. Attached to your location, each spider enemy at attached location gains retaliate and alert. Investigators cannot move out of the location. Test strength or agility 3. If you succeed, discard Sickening Webs. I don't think we want to let that come into play, because we have a really tough time dealing with that test to get rid of it. So I'll opt to Ward of Protection it away. So that didn't happen. And we go to our investigation phase. We add 1 resource from the lone wolf. and now we play down six turns. And let's start investigating. Let's try to investigate both clues from here, or at least one clue, and move out so we don't keep adding doom. And we're investigating 5 versus 2, so minus 3 or better. It's a minus 2. We get one clue, and the second investigate, same thing. 5 versus 2. It's a minus 4. So, unfortunately, we don't have time to stay on this location, so let's just move here. And it's web stairs. Forced after this location is revealed, place one doom on it. Well, that's unfortunate. Okay. But we are at the bottom of the stairs. I may spend the required number of clues, so I spent the 3 clues. We advance the act. And it's the Edge of Dreams. So, we read the scenario interlude, the Spider Queen, and then advance to Act 2. I won't be reading the story part of the interlude, but I'll tell the affecting things that happen. So, we check if Randolph has survived, and he is. We skip to Spider Queen 3. So we add to our campaign log that the investigators are trapped in Atlach-Natcha's realm. If an investigator deck contains Randolph Carter chained to the waking world, remove him from the deck and for the remainder of the campaign. Depending on your difficulty, add a token to the chaos bag as follows. Easy, minus 3, standard, minus 4, hard, minus 5, expert, minus 7. So we add a minus 4 token to the chaos bag. Then we go to Spider Queen 4. We remove each location from the game except for the bottommost location. We shift it so that it's at the 12 o'clock position and do a 8 location circle. And you will see after I paused and done this scenario, this setup part, because takes a long time to do, so you'll see that setup eventually. And then we assemble Atlach-Natcha by performing the following steps in order. Find the double-sided Atlach-Natcha card and flip it to the side that only has art on it. It looks like this, by the way. And we also attach the 4 leg cards to it. And this is maybe my biggest gripe with the scenario. We will be rotating that big spider around, and it's really, really hard to keep the cards in line, and it's just a pain. But it's doable. It's not. It's like a small gripe from me. But the idea is great. So. We place the assembled Atlach-Natcha in the center of the play area between all 8 locations. So one corner of each leg of Atlach-Natcha enemy touches a different location. And you'll see that also soon. And we read the rules, how to play it. Well, I'll just go through how you play it. I do a common mistake with this. You are supposed to rotate the legs clockwise, but for some reason, maybe because I'm left-handed, I'll always start rotating Atlach-Natcha counterclockwise, but I don't think it really matters. But yeah, if you see me do that mistake, don't mind. I'll keep doing the same direction if I notice it, so I don't shift in between plays. Okay, and yeah, there are some triggers that move Atlach-Natcha. So, yeah, let's pause the video for a moment, and I'll do the mid-scenario setup for the Act 2 part, so I will be right back. Okay, so we've done the mid-scenario setup. So now there is 8 locations in play in a circle. They are connected to left and right, and we start at the topmost. Atlach-Natcha is in the middle, and his legs are on those locations that he is touching. So if I here, I'm in the same location as this leg, and some effects make Atlach-Natcha rotate. So we basically just move the legs one location clockmost and rotate this whole pile of cards here. And we also add -4 to our bag, and we remove Randolph Carter from our deck. And yeah, I also did my last action by moving. So that's our turn. We are ready to begin Act 2A, and there's an action. This is why I said earlier that it's good to get additional clues from the starting location, because there's an action: spend one clue, deal 3 damage to an ancient one enemy, and these legs are ancient one enemies, so they have 3 hit points per investigator. So by spending one clue, I can just take out one leg. So it would have been really easy if I had extra clues around, but unfortunately I don't, so we have to start getting clues or do damage some other way. If all 4 legs of Atlach-Natcha are in the victory display, we advance. So our objective is to knock out the legs, and then we advance to the next stage. But that's our turn done. Let's do upkeep. No enemy, the enemy phase. This hasn't any hunters or stuff. These legs are massive, but it doesn't move now. So we just don't do anything with Atlach-Natcha at the moment. And in the Mythos phase, there's a forced ability. When the Mythos phase begins, reveal a random token from the Chaos pack. If the modifier is a negative spin, Atlach-Natcha clockwise x times x is the token's negative modifier. So if I pull a -4, I rotate it 4 times clockwise, not counterclockwise as I usually do. But yeah, that's how we spin the big spider. Let's draw our card in the upkeep. Well, we get haunted, unfortunately, and we get one resource. So yeah, that's the turn, and let's go to the next turn and start trying to knock out these legs. Okay, so we add another doom to the agenda. So there's 6 of 9 doom in play. The encounter card is Ancient Evils. We add another doom. So now it's 7 of 9 doom. And let's see if Atlach-Natcha rotates. So it's a -1. We rotate Atlach-Natcha once. So basically just like this. Okay. So I think I'll just move. I'll take attack opportunity from the leg. It hits actually. I forgot to mention that these legs, this enemy cannot make attacks of opportunity, so I'm free to move away from the legs. and they have a fight value of X, and X is the shroud value of the enemy's location. And if I would evade this enemy, instead of exhausting it, we choose an investigator at location, and this enemy cannot attack that investigator. Okay, so I'll just move and start looking for clues. And it's important to not be at the location if you don't want to get hit in the enemy face. So I think we'll just start moving one way. So first action. First we get the resource from Lone Wolf. We'll move here. And it's the Great Web. There's two clues here. That's great. And if it's not Act 1 and there are one or more fewer clues on this location per investigator, move to the location directly across, so we can basically move from here to here. But I think I won't use that at least this turn. So that's the first action. Second action, we'll investigate. Actually, I think I'll play down the Mists of Relay, learning from past mistakes. So I have a way to deal with enemies that might spawn, because there's really nasty enemies in the deck. There's the Grey Weavers and stuff like that. So it's a nice way to get rid of those without fighting, so we can focus on dealing damage to the legs. Third action, now I'll investigate. So I'm investigating five versus. Actually, I could remove the Haunted. I think I'll wait with the investigation and use my last two actions. So I'm not investigating, but I'm removing the Haunted. This way it helps in the long run. So, enemy phase, nothing happens, no enemies at our location. Upkeep, we draw one card, we get the Ward of Protection, nice, and we gain one resource. So that is that turn, let's go to the next turn. We are now at 8 Doom of 9, and the encounter card is a Web Spinner. Okay, so I think we'll keep on moving this way, so I'll spawn it here. So we can try to kill it next turn. That's the Mythospace ending, so let's see if the big spider rotates again. It's a minus 4. So I'll just do it this way, it's much easier. So basically 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, these are like this, and this is like this. Yeah, this is a bit of a hassle every time the spider rotates, so you could make some kind of rotating apparatus underneath it to just spin it, but I think it's fine. It's a bit of a hassle, but it's not that big of a hassle, quite honestly. Okay, first action. I'll investigate. I'm investigating 5 versus 3. Minus 1 or better. Minus 2 or better. We get a minus 2, so we get one clue. I'll investigate again. It's a minus 1. We get another clue. Third action, move here. And final action, I'll spend one of the clues We'll deal 3 damage to this leg, so it gets defeated and removed to the victory display. And that's my turn. Enemy phase, this web spinner is aloof, so nothing happens. We go to upkeep. Draw 1 card and gain 1 resource. At the end of the round, this guy poops 1 doom here. Well, we are advancing either way next phase, so it really doesn't matter that much. But of course, as I mentioned in the beginning, we don't remove any doom from location, so we start with 3 doom, so that's a bit of a problem, of course. So, upkeep done. That's that turn. Let's go to the next turn. So, we add 1 doom and the agenda advances. So, a lot of story text. And we shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. And the agenda 2 also reads this agenda gets plus 2 doom threshold, and it has a threshold of 9 plus 2, so 11. And we don't remove doom from locations when this agenda advances. Okay. And encounter card is Ancient Evils. So we just add 1 doom here. And let's see if the big spider rotates. It's a minus 1. So it rotates 1 location. Oh yeah, we actually forgot to check what this is. Okay. So we test willpower 3. We would have tested this last turn, but unfortunately I forgot. Let's see, I'm 5 versus 3. It's a 0, so we luckily passed, so nothing happens. Okay. There's 1 clue here. I think this turn will be just to engage this, kill it, and then try to investigate. So first action, we'll engage this web spinner. I'll shoot it with the Derringer. I'm testing 5 versus 2, so I need a minus 1 or better to kill it with 1 shot. It's a skull, so it's a minus 2 unfortunately, so we just punch 1 damage. And the third action, I'll just punch it. So I'm 3 versus 2. Actually, I'll use the gun because I really want to kill it, not waste any more actions on it. So 5 versus 2, it's a 0. Yeah, it dies, takes 2 damage. And last action, we'll investigate. I'll use these painkillers. So I'm 6 versus 4. It's a elder thing. And if this test fails against an attack on a spider enemy, we would place one Doom on the location, but it was an attack. And it was a Elder thing, so... Unfortunately, we could use it to investigate here, but there's no clues there, so it's no point. So we fail, and we don't get the clue. Enemy phase, nothing happens. Upkeep, we draw one card, and we gain one resource. Okay, we get drawn to the flame. If we run into a two clue location, which there are some, we can get many clues fast. That's really, really good. And we also have a board in hand if we draw a bad treachery. But that's that turn. Let's go to the next turn. And we add another Doom. We're already at 5 Doom of 11. Encounter card is Ancient Evils. Well, I'm not wasting the ward on that. If it would be a four-player game, then maybe, but not in this one-player game. Okay, so that is that. Let's see if the Atlach-Natcha spins this turn. It's a minus one. Spins one location. That's actually good, because now we have a fresh leg to kill with one clue. Okay. First action, I'll just take out this leg. And second action, I'll try to investigate. Actually, as a fast action, I'll play down Moxie. And I'll actually use Dexter's ability to discard this. Play the Moxie down with the one discount, so it's free to play. And now I can use Moxie to boost my willpower. I'll use two. So I am now 7 versus 4. Actually, let's go all in. 8 versus 4, so the minus 4s don't fail us. Lucky we did that, because minus 4, and we still pass. And next action, let's move here. After you enter this location, test the agility 3. If you fail, you must either lose one action or place Doom here. I'm testing 3 versus 2 agility versus the difficulty 3. So, let's see. I would lose a bunch of actions, so I actually just have to add the Doom, and let's try to investigate for our last action. So I'm investigating 5 versus 4. Minus 4, no success. So enemy phase, nothing. Upkeep, we draw one card, we get the prevailing, nice. And we gain one resource. That is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. Okay, we add another Doom, so we're at 8 of 11. Encounter card is Grey Weaver. Okay, so this is why I opted to put this mist finally in play. It spawns at our location, and we can't move while it is ready. First action, I'll use the Mist of Relay to evade. And it gives me plus 3 willpower. Oh yeah, and Lone Wolf. I'm testing 8 versus 3, no point in boosting. So we get a cultist, so if we pull another token, if there's an ancient one enemy, oh yeah, let's back up a bit. I forgot to spin the big spider, so let's see. It's a cultist, so as there's no modifier on the cultist, it doesn't rotate. So this was the evasion pool, so next we see what the next token is. It's a minus one, so we evade it. And we need to choose and discard one card from hand. I think I'll discard Shriveling, actually. We want this combo in play, just in case. And we can actually move to another location, so we use that too. We move here. As an additional cost to investigate here, we have to spend one action or place one room at this location. I'll investigate, I'll use two actions to do it. So I'm investigating 5 versus 1. It's a minus 4, so we succeed, we get the clue. Last action, I'll move. Should I move? Yeah. Let's take a risk. When the investigator phase ends, if there is at least one investigator at this location, place one doom. But yeah, we couldn't know. So investigation phase ends, we add one doom here. Oh yeah, this is exhausted. And yeah, enemy phase, nothing happens, upkeep this readies. And we get one card, it's sign magic, and one resource. Okay, now we just need another Shriveling. Play down sign magic and Shriveling, so we have all the things we need. But yeah, that's that turn. We basically have the clues to kill off the legs, but I want to get a couple of more clues. You will see when we advance to the next act, but let's talk about that more when we get there. So that is that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We are one off of advancing. The encounter card is Cryptchill. I'm testing 5 versus 4. If I fail, I can discard. I have plenty of assets that I can discard, so let's just check it. Minus 3, we fail. I'll discard Lone Wolf. It's not that important at this stage of the game. And first action, we'll play Drawn to the Flame. Let's pull an encounter card, and it's Ancient Evils. It would advance, so I'll use Board of Protection to cancel it. And I'll take one horror. And actually, unfortunately, we have to put it on Moxie. So that's a bummer. But at least we get the clues. So two clues. Oh yeah, before our phase would begun. Let's see if the big spider spins again. Minus 2, so it spins 2 locations. 1, 2. 1, 2. Yeah, this is the annoying part, that you're basically trying to catch up with the legs. But yeah. Yeah, that's the Mythos phase done. Basically, then the first action was to use the Drawn to the Flame to get the clues. Their second action, Let's start moving. Okay. We test willpower 3. 5 versus 3. It's a skull, it's a minus 2, so we pass. There's one clue here. And we move again. And yes, an additional cost to investigate here. We need to place one doom or use an extra action. I think I'll investigate and place one doom here. So I'm investigating 5 versus 1. So minus 4 or better. It's a skull, it's a minus 2, so we get that clue. And now we have plenty of clues to just go and try kill Atlach-Natcha's legs and advance. Okay, enemy phase. This is equally far both sides, so this guy starts hunting this way. That's the enemy phase. Upkeep, we draw a card, and we gain one with boss. So that's that. And let's go to the next turn. So now we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. We add one doom, but it advances the act, so we remove these. And again, we only shuffle the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. Fun fact, there were 3 ancient evils in the 5 cards we drew from that. Let's try to shuffle this a bit better, so we don't get so many ancient evils. We're running out of time already. The next agenda card has 11 plus 2 per investigator, so 13. And we already have 6 doom in play. So we don't have many turns to finish this scenario. Let's see how much the big spider spins. Oh yeah, we first draw an encounter card. Will of the Spider Mother. Test willpower 3. If there is a spider in at your base, you can commit cards to this skill. If you fail, you cannot attack or investigate until the end of the round. Okay. A bit of camera problems again. My camera seems to be overheating because it's quite warm in my apartment. So luckily I noticed it in time, so there's not that much to backtrack, and I actually didn't do any skill checks. I pulled up 2 for the rotation for the spider. So, and yeah, we have this, so we can't attack or investigate, because actually I failed that test, but it doesn't matter. We rotate this guy 2 locations. So, and we move 3 times, 1, 2, 3, and we spend 1 clue to get rid of this leg, and that's basically our turn. Enemy phase, this guy hunts here, and that's that. Upkeep, we draw a shriveling, okay, and I think I already added the resource. And that's that. So I think next turn we might be able to kill off the other leg and advance. So let's see how that goes. Okay, so let's go to the next turn. Okay, let's see if we can finish this scenario before the camera heats up again. So we add another doom. And we are at 7 doom of 13. And counter card is a web spinner. I think I'll spawn it here. Actually, if I play down the shriveling. I'll one action move, engage, attack, yeah. I'll play it down here. We might be able to kill the spinner this turn. Oh yeah, I forgot to test this last turn I moved here. Just test it now, so we every time we move into this location, we have to see if we add the doom. And I'm testing 5 versus 3 Elder Sign. Dick will added this to our hand, we would have drawn one more card and it was the Shriveling. So we got the momentum also at the end of our turn. We passed that test. Okay, so now we're up to speed. That was the Mythospace. Let's see how much the Atlach-Natcha spins this turn. It's minus 2, so 2 locations. 1, 2. Okay. Investigation phase, let's move. Actually, we'll play down Shriveling. Second action, move. We move here. Third action, we'll engage. Fourth action. We'll use the Shriveling. So we use one charge, so I only had 3 charges on it. So it's 7 versus 2. So minus 5 or better. It's minus 3. And this web spinner is dead. That's our turn. Enemy phase. This Graveweaver moves here. And we go to upkeep. So we draw one card. Get a Yasatarot, so we can't play assets. Well, we really don't need more assets at this point, so I basically can just ignore that. And we get one resource. So that's that turn. Let's go to the next turn. We add another doom. We are at 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 of 13, so we basically have 5 turns if we don't pull any bad cards, and we get caught in a web. Put caught in a web in the play in your threat area. You get minus 1 agility and cannot take more than 1 move action each round. Test strength 3. If you succeed, discard caught in a web. That's actually quite annoying. We'll try to get rid of that somehow. But let's first see how much Atlach-Natcha spins this turn. In our threat area. Minus 2. So luckily 1, 2. Atlach-Natcha moves there. That's actually perfect. You'll see why in a minute. We start our investigation phase. We move. We only can move once, so that's that. We'll spend one clue to get rid of this leg. And now we can advance. So, the Queen's Rat. We flip Atlach-Natcha's center card over to its enemy side, place it at the location with the most doom on it. And it's this location where we are at. So, Atlach-Natcha is in play there to defeat Atlach-Natcha. We need to do 8 damage. actually we need to do only 4 damage. So yeah, I've been playing this too much as 2 player. So first action. So again, we have the action, spend 1 clue, deal 3 damage to an ancient 1 enemy at your location. And we would spin Atlach-Natcha, so he runs around. If we don't defeat him. But luckily we have enough clues, so our next action, I'll do 3 damage on Atlach-Natcha. But this version hits us, so we take 2 damage and 2 horror. That's fine. We'll hit again. So we take 2 damage and 2 horror. And to avoid getting defeated, the last one of the damages goes to Leo. And we deal another 3 damage onto Atlach-Natcha. We could have also shriveled here, but I'd rather just kill it like this. Okay. If Atlach-Natcha is defeated, we advance. So, we managed to defeat Atlach-Natcha, so we go to resolution 1. In your campaign log, we record that the bridge was destroyed. We earn victory equal to the number of victory points in the victory display, and it's 5. Doesn't really matter, because this is the end of the scenario for this investigator. We also earn 5 bonus experience, so 10 in total. Then we have to resolve the part that recorded in our campaign log, and we are trapped in Atlach-Natcha's realm, so we go to resolution 4. In your campaign log, record the investigator never escaped. If you are playing the Web of Dreams as a 4-part campaign, the investigator win the campaign but are never seen or heard from again. So we win the campaign, but we are forever lost in the Atlach-Natcha's realm. But yeah, that was the Web of Dreams campaign, and I think this last scenario is not that difficult if you know what you're doing. On the blind playthrough, I found it much more difficult because I didn't have the clues already to just kill Atlach-Natcha's second form after the Elks are killed. So, because now I know to store clues before I advance by killing the Elks, I can just get to its location and try to kill it as fast as possible. Okay, but that's the campaign. Let me know in the comments what you thought about Dexter. Do you like how he plays? And what changes would you maybe make on your in your own deck? Have you ordered Dexter's novella? I've been reading it and I really like the novella also. And I really have grown to like Dexter more and more each game I play him in. But other than that, I thank you for watching, and until next time.